Have you ever had a health goal that was really, really important to you, but you struggled to actually achieve it year after year after year? Maybe it was even a personal goal. Maybe it was a relationship goal, a happiness goal, or even just a health, fitness, or weight loss goal. But regardless, maybe you've tried to repeatedly achieve it, but no matter what happens, year after year, or month after month, or day or week after week, you continually fail. Personally, this has happened to me a lot in the quest for achieving my own goals, my own happiness, financial life, and all these kind of things we're all usually striving for throughout our long lives. The thing is that the biggest problem is that once you're going after your goals, if you repeatedly fail, if we repeatedly fail, sometimes that can become a story in our head, become an internal narrative. This internal dialogue can occur anytime we try to start up again for that goal. Now, many of us know this to be true. Every single year, the new year begins. We begin, you know, we've got that fire, that passion, that motivation to once again start on our health goals because they're important and we know they're important. But historically, we know we've failed many times before. Or we've gotten progress, we've gotten some results, but seeing the long-term results, the end goal we want, we haven't been able to reach. And over time, we internalize this. We can go from saying, that was a failure, this was a failure, that year was a failure, that test, trying to do that diet, trying to adhere to this principle, those were all failures, and now I'm a failure. But that right there, that's the million-dollar moment, because that is where you determine your future. So over time, when that moment occurs, when we go from saying, that was a failure, to I'm a failure, that's a very important moment, because right there, you may have just sealed your fate. So once you begin describing yourself as a failure, then it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy in your life. You describe yourself as a failure, so every single thing you do throughout your life begins to reinforce the idea that you're a failure. Maybe you begin quitting things earlier than usual. Maybe you don't even start things that you once started or were once easy to achieve. Now, at the end of the day, the problem is that this can result in us feeling like we're not that confident anymore. We don't have that much self-esteem, or we have low self-esteem, and we feel like we aren't going to achieve our goals, so why bother anyway? What's the point in even starting? So in today's video, I want to show you some interesting research on how you can actually boost your self-confidence, boost your self-esteem, and get over whatever that story is in your head. Because sometimes the only difference between the unsuccessful and the successful is getting over the story you have in your head about why you haven't succeeded or why you can't, and filling it with a brand new one. So in 2012, an interesting psychology study was done. They took adolescents, they divided them into two groups. So what the adolescents had to do was they had to rate themselves in terms of their body weight, their body shape and appearance, and their overall confidence and self-esteem. Now here's the difference. In one group, the adolescents had to use self-affirmations. So affirmations like, I'm worth it, I'm attractive, I'm beautiful, I'm slim, my self-worth is not tied to my physical body or how I appear. The other group had to do no such thing. So the first group had to use affirmations, saying things about themselves positively. The second group didn't do anything. And at the end, both groups had to rate themselves in terms of their body shape, their appearance, blah, 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 their self-esteem, and so on. Can you guess which group felt better about themselves? Clearly, it was the affirmation group, right? They perceived significantly greater body satisfaction, so they felt much more comfortable at home in their skin, in their current body. And also, what's interesting is they had a significantly less perceived threat when it came to rating their own body shape, their own weight, and their entire body and self-confidence and self-esteem. So I found that kind of interesting. They had much lower perceived threat. They didn't feel threatened. They could honestly discuss their weight and their body shape. They told the truth, in other words. They were honest with themselves without taking things personally. So if you're one of the people that maybe you failed before quite a few times trying to achieve your health and wellness goals, or maybe it's a personal goal. Maybe it's a happiness goal, a personal finance goal, going after one of your personal dreams. What can you do, right? How can you boost your self-esteem? How can you boost your self-confidence? Rewrite that story in your head so that you have the motivation and the desire to continue even if you fail. Well, the first thing, number one, use affirmations. Get in the mirror in the morning, as uncomfortable as it might sound, look yourself in the mirror and say, whatever it is, right, you're lacking. So let's say you're lacking a social life. Let's just say, I easily make friends and I naturally make connections anywhere I go. There's a good affirmation for someone who's trying to improve their social life. Or about someone who's trying to lose weight that's failed before. I love my body. I easily, effortlessly adhere to my health goals I set every single day, and I'm committed to getting to the body and the health I want. So sometimes, you know, if you say, I'm a millionaire, that affirmation probably won't work, because if you don't really believe it, if you're obviously not, you won't really internalize it. So one thing you can do is say, I am committed to the process of becoming a millionaire, or I am committed to the process of losing 30 pounds, no matter what it takes, no matter how long it takes me, and I will enjoy the process. So the first thing is use affirmations. The second thing is rewrite that internal dialogue in your head. Pay very close attention to the thoughts you tell yourself. Pay very close attention to the script that's going on, the story that you write in your head, which isn't always the truth and often is not the truth. It's often something we say to rationalize our failures, rationalize someone else's success, or just come up with a story to explain why we are the way we are. So even if you failed many, many times before, year after year after year, you know this is important to you. You know health and weight loss are important to your goals, to looking how you want to look in the mirror after coming out of the shower, to feeling amazing, to being the kind of person you can be to achieve whatever goal you want. Be very attentive, pay very close attention to the story inside your head. Now, inside the Real Food Tribe, a private community of mine, I talk a lot about this. I talk a lot about controlling the internal dialogue, the story in your mind, as well as how to write a new one if your current one is negative, overwhelmingly negative, or it's just not useful anymore. So I also give you tools, techniques, tactics for applying good habits in your daily life, the kind of good tiny habits that'll result in the kind of health and weight loss that you want. Even mental health. By mental health, I mean happiness, emotional health, just really enjoying and loving your life. And you're also going to be filled with people that boost your self-confidence and boost your self-esteem. So if you have a failure, you can share it. And people readily do. And sometimes someone posting a little bit of a success story is all that it'll take to keep you motivated. Now, the Real Food Tribe is not open right now. There's going to be a little box beneath this video. You can add yourself to the wait list, but I will notify you once it opens. Now, before you take off, go ahead, take a second and leave a comment below. Tell me what story is going on in your head. What kind of internal narrative, internal dialogue is preventing you from getting to where you want to be and what you can do to change it. All right, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. Take care. I will see you soon. Make sure to leave a comment beneath this video and I'll see all of you soon.